Hey everyone, it's Sarah here with another DIY. The exploding box.
That worked out great.
Valentine's Day is almost here, so I thought that you guys could use this as a last minute gift idea for your girlfriend or boyfriend or yourself. Seriously, you don't have to have a significant other to make this box. Maybe one of your friends or family members are moving away, going off to college. Maybe you just want to make yourself happy and have something to look at. A box filled with things that you love, like pictures of cats and movies and food. Use it as a birthday gift, a Christmas present, or if you'd rather make a card instead. Last week I posted a DIY string art card, so I'll put that link in the description box below along with my entire Valentine's Day playlist from years past. If any of you are new to my channel, welcome. Please join the family by clicking the red subscribe button below and also pressing that bell icon so you will be notified every single time I post a video, which is usually 2 times a week. I'm kind of experimenting with days right now. Usually I post on Fridays, but I'm kind of just figuring out what works best. Also, let's try to get this video to 10,000 likes pretty please. My birthday is coming up on Monday the 13th, so that would be a great gift. All you have to do is just click the thumbs up button to make me smile. And as a birthday gift for me to you guys, I did film my very first breakfast journal video this past week, so I should be posting the video on Monday, which is kind of a random upload day. But I figured it'd be a really cool way to celebrate my birthday with you guys and do something artsy and fun, so stay tuned for that video. But now, let's get into this one. In order to create the base of the exploding box, I'm using a sheet of cardstock paper that measures just over 30 centimeters each way, or in other words, 12 by 12 inches. Just be sure to use a thick piece of paper so the bottom of the box isn't flimsy. Now what you're going to do is make your paper look like mine. You're going to measure out 9 squares that are 10 by 10 centimeters each. That black piece of paper was just a reference so you guys can pause and see what I did. I drew really thick lines with Sharpie. I'm demonstrating here with a pink piece of paper, as you can see. This is the one I'm actually using for the box. So I thought, why not show you how I make these little lines, even though you guys probably already know just from looking at that black one. So I took a ruler, and this is a really, really old ruler, by the way. I probably had it in first grade, but it's the only one that I could find here that had centimeters on it instead of just inches. So anyway, what I did is I made a little tick mark with a pencil lightly at the 10 centimeter mark, 20 centimeter mark, and 30 centimeter marks, and then I moved the ruler down the page a few times and repeated that process so I could connect the little dots and make straight lines. Once that was complete for one side of the paper, I also repeated that by spinning the paper and making intersecting lines to make 9 squares, and 2 of the sides will be excess that we'll trim off in a second. But first, once you do have all 9 squares, go to the 4 corner ones and draw a diagonal line in all 4 of those. If you can't see what I'm doing, here's that black piece of paper again to magically show you silver lines. Very dark and bold. This is what it looks like on the pink one, and now I'm just trimming off those little edges that are extra. It's like 0.4 centimeters over, so I don't need that. I want it to be a perfect square. Once that's all trimmed away, we're going to create a heart shape in the 4 corners. This is the one I already created as a test, so filming would be a little bit easier. But I'm going to show you how I did it. So I measured about 8 centimeters up the diagonal line, like this. I made a little mark. Then I took a piece of scrap paper, and this is just white computer paper. Seriously, use whatever you have. Fold that in half, and then you're going to mark 8 centimeters up the fold. Now from that mark, you're going to create the curve of the heart and draw a half heart. I suggest you make it a little bit wider than you think you need, because you can always trim it away to fix it later. After the line is drawn, go ahead and cut out that half heart, and then you'll be able to open up the page and reveal an entire heart. It's just easier this way because it creates a mirror image and then your heart looks perfect. Lay the heart down in the square like this, and you'll want the center of it to line up with the line, the pencil line, the diagonal line. So many different ways that I've said that. Then lightly trace around the top of the heart all the way until you reach the lines on the side. So you don't have to finish it at the bottom. Once it hits those lines, then you're done. Repeat this process for all 4 corners. So spin the page, put the heart down, trace it again and again and again, which will result in something like this. You can see me here kind of marking around the heart. This is a spot that you're going to cut. You want to cut around the heart. You don't want to cut the heart off, and you don't want to cut down the entire lines on the side. I did that for all 4 of the heart shapes, and I am left with this. At this point, you're going to lay a ruler down along all your pencil lines that are going straight across. and you're going to fold up the page. The ruler really helps you get a nice straight fold and have a guide to use. Each time you do this, be sure to create a very crisp crease. You'll repeat this for all four sides, and then it will start to look a little bit box-like. But before it can fold into a box shape, we have to also fold the diagonal line inside each heart. You can use the ruler to help you with this as well. You can see that I've done the fold in this heart, and it's folding the heart downwards. So what you do is you have to push the crease up, if that makes sense. So then the heart can fold like this, and it folds inward. See that? And I repeated that for the other three hearts as well, and now it is a box. Well, without a lid. I'll show you how to make the lid at the end, by the way. I'm gonna show you all the other stuff first. At this point though, I am taking an eraser and erasing all the pencil marks so it doesn't look nasty on the inside. You want it to look as clean as possible. Now I am taking my second piece of paper for the inside layer. It's gonna be the first kind of like explosion part, the flap. You're going to repeat the same measuring process that we used for the base, but you're going to just decrease the measurement a little bit. So each square is 9.75 centimeters this time instead of 10. And you are going to trim off the excess around the edges. And this time you're actually going to trim away the four corner squares as well. So it should look something like this. And you're going to fold up at every single line using a ruler to help you. After folding, I erased all the pencil lines and I am also rounding off the top corners of each square just to make it look a little bit more put together. I'm going to insert it inside the base layer like this. Center it as best as you can and then apply double-sided tape to the bottom of just the inside square, which should look something like this, and then stick it down. You can repeat this as many times as you want to create multiple layers. I'm just going to do one more, and this time I made my measurement 9.5 centimeters, so it's a little tiny bit smaller. I repeated those exact same steps and attached the white piece on top. And here you can see I use different patterns of scrapbook paper to create smaller heart shapes, and I taped those to the middle of the corner hearts. This is definitely optional, but if you do it, make sure that the heart is smaller all the way around, and also that the center line lines up with the fold. That's it for the inside of the box. Now we're just gonna move on to doing some decorations. The first very simple decoration element is just some sort of card flap. I'm using these two small pieces of scrapbook paper. The outline I made on the back is a guide so I know where to glue the two pieces of paper together. I used tacky glue to stick these two pieces together, but then I put double-sided tape on the back and I also folded just under the hearts. Attach that wherever you want and then you can hide something underneath and it will kind of look like a card when you flip it open. I'm gonna put a picture underneath mine, and for these I actually went on my Instagram and used a Word document. I used Pages since I have a Mac. So I dragged the pictures to my document and just sized them down to be, I don't know, about 2 inches each. Some of them are less and some are more. Here I'm going to show you how to make a very, very, very basic envelope design. The piece of paper I'm using is 15 by 15 centimeters. It probably could have been a little bit smaller and still been fine, but I just folded in the sides a little bit further. So on the back of the page, you can see that I drew diagonal lines to find the center, and then I just folded two corners in and I put them a couple centimeters past the center because they need to overlap. You can see what I'm doing. So those will join like this and kind of look like butterfly wings or a bow. And then I'm just gonna fold the bottom up like this. You can see that the point hangs over, so you can fold that down and inward. Now apply glue just to that bottom part and make sure that it only sticks to the outside paper. You don't want to glue the envelope together inside, so make sure that it's still a pouch. Then all you have to do is fold the top flap down and you have a little makeshift envelope. I taped it down, added a little burlap bow, and I put this cute little message inside. If you're wondering where I got it, it's actually from a scrapbook pad, a vintage Valentine's themed one I got from Michael's. I didn't show me decorating the entire thing, but seriously, all I did was just tape down pictures, and you can do this on all the layers. These two pictures are from our old house when we lived in Perrysburg, but now I live in Cleveland, well, Beechwood. This is a picture that was taken in downtown Tulsa, and then there's this paper, Forever Love, in the middle, which I haven't actually fastened down yet because I don't know if I want to leave it there. And on this side is a picture from Punta Cana, and I have our initials, C for Craig, S for Sarah. Finally, I want to show you guys how to make the lid, and this is just a test one. I've reused that black paper to make sure that it fit. This time, you'll want to measure 4 centimeters then 10.2 centimeters, and then 4 centimeters. I'm going to use some thick heart scrapbook paper. It's kind of like a cardstock thickness. And then I am going to draw this grid like so and make it look exactly like the black sheet of paper, but you know, not messy. I've also marked where you're going to cut at each corner. You'll want to cut that left line on all 4 corners. And either before, during, or after, you'll want to fold up all the pencil lines with the ruler again. After everything is folded and cut, apply double-sided tape to the pattern part of each corner. So that little square I just folded to the inside like this, and I repeated that for all 4. Now all you have to do is squeeze the box together in order to put the lid on. I've probably watched a dozen different tutorials of different designs and ways to decorate, so I can list some of those in the description box below to give you guys even more inspiration. I hope you enjoyed this video, and please join the So Craftastic family if you have not yet by clicking the subscribe button and also the bell icon so you'll be notified every single time I post a video. I like to upload DIYs and artsy crafty videos along with other things, and I try to post 2 times a week every week. Here's what mine looks like. I don't think it's too tight or too loose. It does take a little bit of tinkering around to get the flaps to go in, but once you get the hang of it, it goes on nicely. For watching. I hope to see you back here on Monday for this breakfast journal video. It's my very first one, and you guys have been requesting this for ages. I finally felt like doing it. So if you're excited for this series, I know I am, please click the thumbs up button to let me know. Also, there's a new video over on the Leo McWhiskers channel, aka my cat. He was rolling around in snow. So you should go check that out. I'll put the link in the description box below, along with all my social media information, so you can follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook, and Crafty Amino. I hope you guys have a great rest of the day, and see you soon in my next video. Bye!